Breaking now, Governor Wolf's office says he plans to veto the bill that just passed the state Senate. That's a bill that would give school districts the say on how many fans can attend games. The governor's office says the bill is unnecessary because school districts already have control about decisions on school sports. But everything is still up in the air because even if he vetoes it, the state legislature could reverse it. And it is all coming down the wire.
Skylight starts Friday night in just 48 hours. Channel 11's Jillian Hartman explains what happens now.
Well, everyone in the sports world has their eye on Bill 2787. The head football coach here at Gateway says this stadium can hold 5,000 people and believes there's plenty of room to safely social distance fans in the stands.
Do I think there's room? There's an in-between, you know, a full packed house of everybody jammed together in a student section and an empty stadium with no fans. I think there's a middle ground, and I hope that's where we're headed.
This is a big win for many families, teams, and schools across Pennsylvania. House Bill 2787 passed in the Senate late this afternoon, leaving the decision up to each school district regarding fans at indoor and outdoor games.
People take this very seriously. It's not like we're just picking numbers out of thin air. You know, we've done measurements of our stadium and all of our facilities.
The athletic director hopes to have more fans in the stands if the governor signs the bill into law. As of right now, fans are technically allowed at games under the governor's new guidance, but the maximum 250 person limit makes it almost impossible to have spectators at high school football games. However, Gateway is making it work. At this Friday's football game, they're allowing parents of senior players, band members, and cheerleaders to attend. But Hall understands why many people have concerns about the bill.
I do get it. You know, we don't want to have a free-for-all. We don't want to have, you know, everybody just come in and don't wear your mask and jam the student section together and have 5,000 people sitting on top of one another.
The governor has up to 10 days to sign or veto the bill. If he vetoes it, the legislature can override the veto with a two-thirds vote. Reporting in Monroeville, I'm Jillian Hartman, Channel 11 News.